Hello friends, in today's lecture I will discuss in brief about vector cardiography. Vector cardiography, normally known as VCG, is the technique of analyzing the electrical activity of the heart by obtaining electrocardiogram, that is ECG, along three dimensional axes of the body. The initial concept of VCG was introduced in 1920. Later, an improved VCG system was developed by E. Frank in mid-1950s. The basic idea is to construct three orthogonal leads containing all the electric information. It gives the representation of distribution of electric potential generated by the heart and produces loop-type patterns on the CRT screen. The display of information is known as vector cardiogram. Vector cardiogram is obtained by means of a continuous series of vectors, that means it will have magnitude as well as direction, that form curving lines around a central point. The three vectors corresponding to three leads are represented as right to left axis, that is x vector, head to feet axis, that is y vector, and front back axis, that is z vector. The x vector is taken as the potential between the two points under the arm. The y vector is between the head and the right leg. The z vector is from the front to the back of the body. Now let's see how Frank's method is used to determine the three vectors. Frank's method directly generates orthogonal projections over the cardiac plane, that is the sagittal plane, or I can say vertical plane. Another, we have frontal plane and transverse plane or horizontal plane. Each projection records simultaneously the same electric episodes on two perpendicular axes. The sagittal plane records simultaneously on axes y and z. The frontal plane records simultaneously on axes x and y. And the horizontal plane records simultaneously on axes x and z. Each of the three components is detected with the same sensitivity. The major information that these provide is the direction of depolarization and repolarization of atria and ventricle. Now, to calculate the Frank's lead, that means x, y, z, using the standard lead system, that is 12 lead system, we have already discussed in last lecture, the expressions that can be used are as given as equation 1, 2 and 3. Equation 1 is for x, equation 2 is for y, and equation 3 is for z. In these equations you can see we are using V1 to V6, that were the precordial leads, and 1, 2 that are standard limb leads. From these scalar coordinates it is possible to obtain the instantaneous cardiac vectors. So, the Frank method was an improved system for spatial vector cardiography which made VCG clinically practical. Further, I will just highlight one more term, that is inverse problem of cardiography. The inverse problem of electrocardiography is defined as the determination of the electrical function of the heart from a number of remote recordings of potentials on some non-invasive or minimally invasive surface. That can be electrocardiographic or vector cardiographic. Both diagnoses can be an inverse problem. Inverse problem of electrocardiography is used in its more formal sense to mean the reduction of electrical information about the heart by mathematical manipulation of the measured potentials on the body surface. So this is all I would like to discuss in this lecture. Thank you so much.